Hey there, Skier Noob, yet again back with another video. And today, my dudes, today I'm going to show you 3 hacks to make your Slimefun experience way easier. So you guys, to start off, I know how annoying it is to use the grindstone or the enhanced crafting table, and I'm going to show you guys how to save a lot of time on it. So if you guys do not know what the enhanced crafting table or the grindstone is this thing. It allows you to get more items if you put it in here. So if you put a blaze rod in here, you'll get 4, a bone instead of 3, you get 4. It's really, really handy. And of course, for all the magical items, you are going to need this because you have to change the nether ward into magical lumps and the ender eyes into ender lumps to make magical items. What I use this for is what I used to use it for is changing cobblestone into gravel, so I didn't have to go underwater to go look for a gravel to change it into sifted ore. So you guys, right now I'm using this. I used to use this, but right now I'm using this. And you guys, with this, I mean this. So the items, normally I have an interface right here because this android would be mining the blocks on the sides. Then it would take the cobblestone, put it into the interface, and the interface would push it into here. And what are these things? These things are ore grinders. If cobblestone are in this, it changes into clay or flint or gravel. As you guys can see, the gravel thing is what I use it normally for. And then it will take the gravel out, push it in here, and it will change the gravel that is inside of here into sifted ore, clay, or flints. Then it will push the items here. I blocked it off right here so so it wouldn't take the items out. And right here is where all the sifted ore goes, and then right here is where all the flint and all the clay goes, and then the sifted ore will send will go through here and will go into this electric dust washer, and the dust washer is going to change the sifted ore in all the different kind of dusts, and then eventually the items will flow in here into this chest, and then the chest will go into the elevator. The elevator pushes the items up, and then each dust will go to its separate chest. As you guys can see, this thing works perfectly. It's beautiful. I used it a lot. I have my beacon right now, so that's why I don't have any iron dust. But as you guys can see, it really works with the gold, because look at this, you guys. I have already had 2 chests full of it. Well, I think it's almost, well, yeah, 1.5 chests, let me just say that. It's beautiful. It works perfectly. And eventually I'm going to show you guys how to make this thing. It's really not that complicated. People think that it's super complicated, but it isn't. It's just kind of hard to get all of the items, but I'll show you guys how to do it. For now, let's go back to the basic stuff. So you guys, we all know the pain of putting the items inside of the enhanced crafting table and then right clicking it. And if you could spam it, or you try to take the items out, you are going to have to take the item out, click on it again, take the item out, click on it again, take the item out, and take it out, and click it again. I know, this is gonna take years in this fashion. So today, you guys, I'm gonna show you how to make that process a little easier. So you guys, I thought it would be smart to show you guys how it works first before I show you guys how to make it. So eventually this is how it's going to look like. As you guys can see, there is really not that much to it. It's basically just a little item filter what takes the items out without you having to do it yourself, and then puts it inside of the chest, and it just makes life way easier. So remember how you had to click and then take the items out, click and take the items out? Right now, if you just wait a half a second between the clicks, right now if you spam it, it will still do it, but if you just wait a half a second between it, as you guys can see, you can save a lot of time, and it's gonna make you a lot of items. As you guys can see already, I had 11 in there already, so we made about 15 and not even 10 seconds. So that was really, really, this is gonna save you a lot of time. And as you guys already know, you can make gravel with cobblestone. So right now, right here, I put gravel in this. You're going to need 7 of the items that you actually want to filter, and you're going to put it in here with 4 signs, and then if you click on this one, you can actually spam click, but don't spam click it too much, because the gravel can also change into flint eventually if you spam click it too much. So just keep that in mind. If you want to avoid that, you could put a hopper facing into this with some named items, so that if this stack is gone, it will fill it with a named item, and then it will just start changing this cobblestone into gravel again. And as you guys can see, boom, we already have 1.5 stack. If you do this like 5 minutes, you guys, I it's way easier than going down into the water and trying to sift everything with your little gold pen. Eventually, you guys, if you have the whole system, it's way easier than doing it all by hand, because it's still annoying to do it with the gold pen. So without me rambling too much about this, you guys, I'm going to show you how to make this right now. So guys, for the people who do not know how to make this by just looking at the last clip, I'm going to build this together with you guys. So all the items that you are going to need are inside of my inventory. You're going to need 6 random blocks. It doesn't really matter which blocks, but I use quartz because they are easy to destroy. We have 1 dirt block. This is a junk block. We are going to get rid of it eventually. 1 redstone comparator, 1 repeater, 1 redstone torch, 2 hoppers, 1 chest, 4 signs. You can only use signs. It doesn't work with other items. And 2 redstone dust. And of course, 7 of the items that you want to filter. So if you want to make magic lump 2, you cannot put magic lump 1 in there, okay? It's kind of obvious. And of course, the items that you're the machine that you want to be filtering out of. So right now we are going to use the enhanced crafting table. So now that I have all the items inside of my hand, let's start building this. So you guys, we are going to start by placing a block, and on top of that block you are going to put a redstone repeater facing the way that you are going to put the chest in, okay? Then we are going to place a block right here, and then build over 2 blocks on top of this. So 1 and 2, there we go. Then we're going to place 1 block on the right and 1 on the left. And then 1 block right behind this redstone repeater. On these last 2 blocks on behind here, we are going to put 2 redstone dust. One right here, one right there. And this is basically what it's going to be. Then you are going to take your chest out. I'm going to place it right here. Remove this block. And you can remove this block too. Boom. Like so. You are going to put a redstone torch right here. Boom. On this one. And then face a hopper inside of the chest. Place 1 redstone comparator facing this way. So look at the redstone dust. Place it down like so. Take one hopper. Look at the side, like right next to this one. Crouch and then right click. Place it on like so. Beautiful. Works perfectly. No problem. Then we are going to take the crafting table and the dispenser like so. Oh, oops. On top, place the dispenser right here. Well, we all know how to make the enhanced crafting table. Boom, like so. Beautiful. And this is all to it, you guys. This is everything you had to do. It's really not that hard. As you guys can see, we built this in not even 2 minutes. Then we are going to put the items right here underneath. And you're going to make sure if the items flow into the hopper when you place it in, you did something wrong. Okay, and then you just have to rewatch the video. But if you put the signs in right now, it should be working. Put the 7 items right there. As you guys can see, 1 is going to go inside of this hopper. There, and it's going to be stuck in there. Nothing in there. And now we can put the items in here. Like so. 16. Boom. And as you guys can see, every time you click, it switches over. So every time an item goes in here, this redstone will extend itself to this block. This block will activate. It will change the redstone hopper to deactivate, and it will let 1 item flow through it. That's why you have to wait the half a second in between, because the redstone torch will go off. Do you see that? It will go off and it will allow 1 item to flow in it. So as you guys can see, we already made 10, And that's how you make this. The same goes with the grindstone. You just have to build this part again. And then instead of placing the enhanced crafting table on it, you could put the grindstone on it. So let's move on to the next thing. Oh, you guys, I almost forgot. You guys do not place two of these modules right next to each other. If you do, if this redstone currency will extend, it will extend this one too. It will activate this one too, which is going to activate this one. And while you are going to take items out of these, it will take items out of these two and just mess everything up. So don't put them right next to each other. Make sure that you have one space in between them. So as most of you guys know, you can duplicate your iron with the Slimefun. And the way to do that is with the ore crusher. If you go inside of the basic machines right here, the fourth thing that you have right here is called ore crusher. As you guys can see inside of here, if you put one iron ore in it, you'll get two iron dust. And then you will have to use the smeltery to smelt the dust back into iron. So, and I know you guys, some of you went like,
"Hey, Oscar, Captain Obvious, like we didn't know that."
Well, I just explained that for the people who actually didn't know, okay? So don't do this to me. So you guys, this is the smeltery. If you don't know what the smeltery is, it's inside of the slime fun book, and it's right there. It shows you what you have to do, and some people don't understand what it means if the flint and steel is under it, but it means that you have to fire the block up. You actually have to lit the light. Oh my god, you have to light the block underneath the furnace itself. I like to use a netherrack because it stays on even though you don't need it. If you put the normal block, the fire will eventually go out, but the fire will go out if you use the smeltery too, you guys. So if right now we have the dust in there, and if we right click it a couple of times, as you guys can see, the fire goes out eventually, and we only could make four. This is random, you guys. Sometimes you can only use it once, sometimes you only use it four times, and it's just annoying when you're trying to get like a full stack of items. It's just annoying that you have to go back down and light it up again. I'm going to show you guys how to make this thing a little bit easier, and we're going to need all the items that are inside of this chest. So you are going to need about 9 flint and steel. That's what's going to fill the dispenser. 1 observer and 3 redstone dust. You can put a hopper and a chest on it if you want to put additional flint and steel in there, so it will last a little longer. Because if you fill one double chest in there, you will probably use it for a couple of days, and then you have to refill it. Depends on how many things you are going to make. So if you guys don't know how to make an observer, if you are in 1.12, you have this little book, you can click on it, make sure that it's showing all, and then you are going to go to the redstone, and right here you can click on observer, and it shows you are going to need 6 cobblestone, 2 redstone dust, and 1 nether quartz. So you guys, now that I got all the items inside of my inventory, I'm going to show you how to make this. So we are going to start with the dispenser, and we are going to place right next to the place that you are going to lit on. So this is the block which we are going to place the fire on, so right next to it. Then we are going to take the observer, and we're going to place it just like this, boom, right there. So just make sure that both of the faces of the observer and the dispenser are facing towards the netherrack. Then you are going to take the redstone and just connect these two with each other like so. I would advise to put the fire on first and then put the items in, because if you do it the other way around, you will have to break the redstone again and then put it back again for it to work. And I don't mean this one, because it wouldn't make a difference. You just have to remove it so that it doesn't turn the fire off instead of putting the fire on. So right now you could put, if you want, a hopper right behind it. You could put it on top of it, or just like so, and then put the chest on here, put the flint and steels in here, and if you make it a double chest, you guys, you could fill it with enough flint and steel to go on for days. So right now I'm gonna put in, I did this once before, but I fudged up, so I'm doing this again. As you guys can see, there's 44 in there. You know how we did it, we had to click on it. Do you see that? Oh, I like that. The fire goes out, But I can just spam click this, actually. Look at that. We had... How much did we have? Well, we had over 44, I think. And we did it in this short amount of time. As you guys can see, this will change your life. So let's go to the next hack. By the way, you guys, if you're play townie, make sure that you toggle the fire on your plot. Because if you don't toggle it, you won't be able to turn it on. Look at this. Fire is disabled. It won't work. You will have to do plot toggle fire. And I lost my... Yeah, as you guys can see now, it's enabled. Boom. There we go. And you can do it. So if you're running that problem, you know what to do. So you guys, for the last hack, we all know that dust is a really big part of Slimefun. As you guys know, if you upgrade, if you unlock everything in the basic mechanics, we don't have the furnaces because of the glitch that's happening right now. But if you unlocked all of the basic mechanics, it will allow you to open the energy and electricity. And for these, we are going to need the ingots and the alloys, and these alloys and ingots are made of dust, and sometimes sometimes these dusts are really hard to get. I'm talking about lead and silver. I used to have a hard time trying to get these, and when you ask people around, they're like, but we don't have one, or we are having a hard time getting it ourselves. So today, you guys, I'm going to show you guys how to get these for yourself. So this is not something that you can do in a large amount, well, unless you don't mind clicking a lot. I'm just going to say that right now. But if you need like one or two or maybe five or six silver dust, and so nobody wants to give it to you, I have a tactic to get it yourself. So you are going to, of course, need sifted ore, the dust that you actually need. So it can be lead, it can be copper, it can be silver, whatever, it doesn't really mind. And 7 blocks that cannot be detected by the dust washer itself. So if you have that, just open the dust washer. Already have the sifted ore. You can put the silver dust in there, and then just fill everything else by a block that cannot be detected by the machine itself. So right now it's going to tell you, sorry, my inventory is full. But if you spam this, as you guys can see, right now we have 2. And this actually works. I stumbled on this by accident. I was bored. I was just trying to get myself, and nobody wanted to give me some silver. And I just kept on clicking on it. And then it did it like after 2 clicks, it did this. And I was like, what? That actually works? So let me see how much we can get in like maybe 10 seconds. Well. Okay, you guys, that was really not much. It was really not much. I thought it was going to be more, but we were lucky the first few times. But this is really handy if you are down 2 silver and you really, really need 2 silver and nobody wants to give it to you. So, you guys, these were my 3 hacks for you. So, you guys, if this tutorial was at least a little bit helpful to you, don't forget to smash that like button. And of course, if you're new to my channel, subscribe for some more videos. I'm going to be building this town. As you guys can see right now, it's kind of dead and I really didn't do much. I was trying to unlock everything in Slimefun, as you guys can see right now. I really do have everything unlocked in Slimefun, literally everything. So now that I'm done with that, I'm going to make the towny episodes about building the town. So that's what I'm going to do. You guys, don't forget, if you think this video can help a friend of yours, don't forget to share it with them. And yeah, leave a like and subscribe if you're new to my channel. And of course, have an amazing day. Oh, really, I don't, just be nice and leave a like. Oh, by the way, guys, I know this is probably obvious for most of the people, but if you put 3 of these things right next to each other and make 2 of these enhanced crafting table, and you put the nether wards in this one, and then change this into magic lump 1, then change this into magic lump 2, and then change the 3rd one into magic lump 3, you can actually make it so that if you put the items in here, you can crush them really fast, take them out, put them in here, and then do this really fast and then take the items out of here and then put them in the tier 3. So that's what I've been doing when I was in Noob. Now I have the automatic crafting table, so I really don't have to do this on my own anymore. So that was really a tip for the ones that actually didn't know, because, you know, I'm all about the noobs, you know. I love you guys.